What was a hobby almost cost a local man his life about 18 months ago. Tonight, this survivor is alive and well, and that hobby is now his profession.
In October of 2009, Ed Cooley was close to death at the bottom of a cliff.
So I was there at Twin Falls, and I was just looking at the falls, and the cliff that I was standing on above the falls just collapsed, and I dropped about 20 feet and landed half in the creek and half out of it.
He was by himself, the pain unimaginable.
My pelvic was broken too, and my leg was just crushed.
Fortunately, this Rogers native had a satellite call device that sends out the GPS coordinates. A massive search was mounted, and he was found 7 hours later.
I wasn't sure I was going to live. As a matter of fact, I was pretty sure that I was not going to live because it got dark, and you'd be amazed at the kind of clarity that gives you when you really think about, you know, what's really important.
After several surgeries, it took 6 months before he could walk again normally. Life and what you do with it took on new meaning after the accident.
Well, the thing that inspired me is after that, I just decided that I was done with the day job and I just wanted to do this full time. I mean, this is what I enjoy doing. You look at these scenes and it's incredible, and you can only imagine just standing there.
It was clear to Cooley, even after that lonely night of the accident, what he was going to do with his second chance in life.
I just really enjoy doing this. I mean, being out in places that you don't get very often, and it's like an adventure. You go and try to find things that are at unusual times of the day or unusual weather. You look at some of these, they're taking either right before or right after sunset.
He says it's an adventure. You plan it all out. He even has to go back day after day to the same spot just to capture that magical shot in the right light.
And, you know, that's a big part of what I like to do is just you soak it in. You know, you're there, and even if the weather's bad and it's raining, you just kind of embrace it, and it's incredible, just the feeling. And you almost get addicted to that feeling.
You can see why. It's an addiction that's paid off for Ed. The White River Gallery will have its grand opening June 10th in downtown Rogers, and most of the beautiful pictures you'll see displayed were taken since he came so close to death almost 18 months ago.